Nuke baking and review. Nuke workfile. Nuke render. Nuke slate still. Baked QuickTime. Transcode. Burn-in. Slate merge. Nuke review is quite flexible. Let me explain the steps that control the result. Nuke workfile is used to render the output to be published. The render is loaded as a read node to the workfile. Nuke is used to render a QuickTime from the main render. Workfiles is also used to render a slate PNG file if Nuke slate is detected in the node graph. The QuickTime is transcoded by FFmpeg to the desired output format. The FFmpeg is used to add burn-in to transcode. Transcode with burn-in is concatenated with the slate. Let me separate the steps to the render, baking the movie from the render, and converting the movie to review. You can have more than one render in the workfile. Each render can be configured to produce more than one movie. For example, with and without look applied. Each baked movie can be transcoded to one or more reviews. Using filtering in settings helps to limit the amount of review files. Now I will describe each step in more detail, showing the settings that control the result. Nuke workfile. Color space settings used for write node can be found in color management and output formats. Nuke render as a read node is controlled by Nuke color preferences, so rendering to float OpenEXR will use ACES AP0. The first step for creating the review is to render a ProRes 4444 QuickTime out of the main render. You can bake input process used as a look in OpenPype, bake viewer LUT with OCO display node, and you also have an option to reformat the output. Note that you can have more than one QuickTime output. Here is the example baking definition with look and viewer baking, and look off definition with just viewer process baking and reformat node. If OpenPype detects a slate node connected to the render node, it will also render a slate still out of Nuke for every extract review data movie output definition. Next step transcodes the QuickTime using FFmpeg to desired output format. Extract review profiles allow you to filter by hosts and families, so you might decide to create H.264 and MP4 container to render family out of Nuke, for example. You can also specify the name of the burn-in profile to be used. The tags offer even more flexibility. You can control if you want to add burn-in, add slate frame and so on. FFmpeg arguments are driving the actual transcode settings. You can also decide to crop away or overscan, resize to particular resolution, and add a letterbox. You can define more than one transcode profile. Here is an example ProRes output with semi-transparent letterbox, and DNX QuickTime forced to 1920 by 1080. Next step retranscodes review while adding burn-in. The format options define text size, placement and color. Profile definitions demonstrate keywords in curly brackets to be replaced during burn-in generation. The final operation is only applicable if you use Nuke Slate. The Slate PNG is concatenated by FFmpeg with review from step above. This concludes Nuke baking and review.